Didn't make any plans and now you sort of want a night out on the town? Well, there's an app for that. Live Hotspot NYC is a smartphone app that gives you all the details for a great night out in the big city. J.D. Awad is the founder of Live Hotspot and is here as our guest on The Arise. Welcome to the program. Your father, by the way, is one of our favorite guests.
Thank you.
So there's
no
pressure on you at all.
Right. Here. Big shoes to fill.
Tell me a little bit about the app and why did you decide
to create it? Live Hotspot is an app that tells you what's going on in real time in bars and clubs in New York City. We're telling you lines, cover charges, celebrity sightings, music genre, and then we're giving you access into those events through the app.
Okay, so how did you get started? Why did you decide to do this?
Well, I started off in finance, and I had this idea. I was at a dinner one night and I had run the idea by a friend. You know, what do you think if you had a live feed telling you what was going on at venues before you got to the door? They said it sounded great, so I ended up hiring a Craigslist developer. I launched a blog and in the first month we had 100,000 visits. So I left the finance job and I went full running with this and raised some money from a VC firm.
Okay, so you got some money behind you.
So what are the steps
then to publicizing this and getting this out there in the marketplace?
Right. Well, you know, a lot of money ends up going to technology.
Sure.
So you kind of have to figure it out on a grassroots level. Luckily for me, I started off in nightlife. You know, I grew up here, so I had enough connections in the industry to kind of get my, the ball rolling, so to speak. And then when the app launched, we did a launch event with one of our partner venues, and there's no competition right now. So that kind of separates us from a lot of the other reservation apps that are out there in the space.
So how do you aggregate all of the content then?
Right.
You know, is this manually done or is it scalable where you're having venues sort of pump you the information?
Right. So we're partnered up with groups that are running nights at each venue. And part of the deal is they'll feed us the information and then in return through our concierge service, we'll send them business. And they get paid how many people come to the venue off bar sales. So we're kind of aggregating all the content for free. And in return, we're sending them business.
Okay, so right now you have about 40,000 downloads, which is impressive for a new app. You don't charge for the app, what is the business model here that's going to make you money?
So venues are now coming to us, and they want featured placement on the app. So on a Friday night when there's 30 or 40 different venues hosting events, you know, we'll probably aggregate all that list to 10, the top 10.
And so they would pay for a placement.
Well,
but doesn't that run into the credibility, though, of the app? So if I'm looking at this app, and all of a sudden I know that people or groups are paying for higher placement.
Right.
Would that, you know, does that worry you about the credibility?
So throughout the day we're featuring the event. So we're saying tonight, you know, Club X is going to have this person, Club Y is going to have that person. And then once midnight strikes, we're doing the live feeds. We're saying there's a line here, the cover charge is $50 or whatnot. So at nighttime it's objective. During the day, the venues that are paying us, we're featuring their events on the site and the app. And then we're giving you access through our VIP package. So you can cut the line, guaranteed admissions, VIP hosting table. And we're giving you access to these events at a fraction of the cost of what it would be if you went to the door and tried to get on your own.
Do people also provide any feedback? Is it a two-way street where they could say what the events were like?
Right. The major feedback we have right now is on the App Store. We have, I think, 100 to 120 positive reviews on the app. We actually send a questionnaire to our concierge members after we provide a service and everything has been with flying colors. You know, I think the major thing here is that we're trying to get the regular person to get into, you know, the highest end venues or whatever event they want to go to at a reasonable cost.
There are so many apps out there, especially on the Apple Store right now. So how are you going to break through and stand through so you get the app out to the most people possible? And do you think at some point we're kind of in an oversaturated app market?
Right. I think in this space, absolutely, there is definitely oversaturation. But I feel like the majority of the apps in this space are reservations. They want you to buy tables, buy bottles, buy these high spends on the app and commit to that spend before you get to the venue. So we meet with other companies all the time to see if we can do some sort of cross promotion. And literally all they're doing is they want you to download the app, put your credit card information in, and charge you immediately.
What do you think is the exit plan then for you?
Well, we've been contacted. We've been contacted by groups in other cities that want to roll out a franchising model. Mm-hmm. I think at the end of the day, if we had a multi-city operation, you know, I would be happy with that. But I think we want to dominate the New York City market before we go into other cities. So if every single person that goes out in New York is using Live Hotspot as a tool to plan their night, I think
You know, we have about 30 seconds left, but have you thought about going to cities where the nightlife is not so prominent that people really do need help finding a place?
Not so much, just because more of the feedback that we've gotten up to this point is to hit the major cities that have a nightlife presence. D.C., Miami, L.A., San Diego. So that's kind of on the pipeline right now.
Okay, J.D., thank you for stopping by.
Thank you for having me.
On the Arise today. Appreciate it. Tomorrow on Arise Exchange, we will have more on the Keystone Pipeline. The U.S. House is expected to vote. We will bring you the latest developments. Let's take a look at the markets. Once again, the Dow did finish the day up about 40 points to 17,652. Energy stocks, though, weighed on the markets overall as oil has now plunged to below $75 a barrel. I'm Andrew Schmertz. Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.